What's up, guys? Craig here, Dragon Star Hobbies. We're gonna be playing some standard today with Nate. Nate's brought Marty vehicles. I'm gonna be playing Four Colors of Healy. Our lists are based off the well performing list we've seen recently in GPs. So we're gonna start off with a dice roll. We're gonna do closest to seven without being seven. Alright, five. So you got a nine, that's two away. I was two away. Six. Yeah. Alright, so I'll be on the point. So I end up keeping my hand. It's awkward because like I feel like I always have this card and I don't have the actual green source. But we do have this, we have the ability to get our green source for this, so it'll be fine. We also have a piece of the puzzle, so we're gonna go with this.
I will probably keep this since I don't really know what I'm playing against at this moment. I have a couple turn one options and turn two options.
Yeah, so I'm going to start off with an Aether Hub. I'm going to get an energy. I'm going to immediately spin it and cast Aether and get two. I'm going to get a four, so I'm going to pass. Draw a card.
Start with Concealed Courtyard. Tap it and play Full Craft Exemplar. And pass.
Server and a conduit. Go ahead.
Walking Ballista for one. And go to combat. Swing for three.
Because we don't want him to have additional pressure on this card next turn, and it doesn't have first strike yet, we're going to go ahead and block this, because like we're not worried about this just killing our guy this turn. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to block. That's a Healy. I'm going to plus. Really damage to you. And I'm going to keep that on. Yeah, I'm going to keep that on top.
Play an Aether Hub. Get an energy. Aether Sphere Harvester.
Good.
Mentors get two energy. And pass.
You don't want to attack the Walking Ballista?
Oh, yeah. I mean, don't worry. I'll. Yeah, no, I don't have to say that. And then I'll pass.
I'll put that on the bottom. And then I'm gonna pass.
Go ahead and crew.
Okay.
Grand Sealy.
No block.
Alright.
Okay, Spider Slide. Alright. I'm gonna use 5 energy, so go down to 3. Go down to 4.
Yeah. Second main. Play a Raven Inspector.
Yeah, got Chris, baby.
Get a clue. Tap 2 for Karam. And pass.
Alright, we're gonna plus up. We're gonna keep that on top. We're gonna start off with Oath of Chandra here.
Direct to Sealy.
Yeah, that worked. Cheat drafts is the best. Cheat drafts in so many winter decks, though. He's got the three. What is this pile? And he's like, alright.
For two?
Okay, we can make this work.
Good. Tap to crew.
Cool.
Get a combat. That's the healer.
I'm gonna pay energy and cast harness lightning there, so it's gonna take down to two.
And pass.
I'm gonna plus the possibility. Put it on the bottom. And you guys weather virtuosos?
Mm-hmm.
Get 3 energy. I'll pass.
Crack the clue.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, and I'm gonna pass turn.
It's not really as much thing. I'll start off by plusing slightly. Put it on the bottom. I'm gonna do it with Nissa. You got a Whirler versus Nissa.
Got there.
I'm gonna get 3 energy, so I'm gonna get 8.
I want for turn.
Chris, you just slide down 1 hit. I feel like this is too much.
Play a Gideon.
That way you can beat whatever. That way you can smash me.
I think I'm gonna plus up here.
Sorry, buddy.
Because of Oath of Chandra, it puts me in an awkward position if he top checks a regular Chandra.
Think about this, Chris. You're getting fed by something.
And I'm going to pass.
Well, that's perfect.
This way, you can
take a random card.
Yeah, okay.
Chris,
I'm going to
close him off. Near Gideon.
Yeah.
I'm gonna do it again. I'm gonna have to pay energy down to 6 or 7. I'm gonna play 2 servants. Get 4 energy. And
yeah, that's shiny taking.
That was a bit of shiny in every pack.
I know. Take the shiny. Why are you trying to make this hard with this kid, man? He's doing us a favor, Chris.
I'm gonna go ahead and
this, we would
plus Gideon.
Oh god, that's
scary. Go to combat. Targeting stimuli.
I'm gonna pay 3 to make a
profit. Second main.
Alright, modern players! That's round 2. Robert!
Play 12 pack, 3 hits. Play my land for turn. And
I'm gonna go to 2 and make 2 Thopters.
Okay.
I'll start off with an Ocean.
Sort of.
I went
on the side and you have to get up. What?
Cover that you're not hitting land drops.
I was grinding.
Good.
I got a place. Alright, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna minus two.
I'm targeting it.
Where are they?
Okay.
I'm gonna make a copy and get free energy. Copy. I'm gonna move to combat.
Okay.
I'm gonna attack with all of these. So two whirlers, two servers, two doctors. I'm going to block here and go 4 damage. I'll slow down. Tap 4 out of here.
I'll need to get slow down. Yeah, yeah, I told him I'm not going to.
But I'm not that brave. Not to mention I just had a bunch of 4 drops.
So it's probably good that our opponent mulled again because we're basically working with the nuts here. This is gonna hurt. I'm just gonna give it to you this round before sideboard.
Alright, Dex.
You're about to get aggro dot deck this game.
We can keep this. This is pretty good. So we'll keep this almost dry. It's fine. Like, it's kind of awkward because it's a high drop, but it lets us do this, so it's fine. We'll keep that, and you're good.
So, inspiring tool craft. Pass.
I got energy off this.
Yeah.
heart for three.
So this would be really good if that wasn't our only land.
Play forest. And we're going to pay energy and Oath of Chandra. Go ahead.
Get a clue. And pass.
Get an energy and we're going to use it immediately to cast World Refiner. And then get 2 energy and draw a card. Pass.
Oh, okay.
Land for turn? That way, yeah. Tap the crew. Combat for 4. And pass.
Use energy. I'm gonna balance the Oath of Chandra. Some attacks. I'll attack for 3.
Go to 17.
Okay.
Pass. Aether Sphere Harvester.
Good.
Tap to crew. Tap to group. Combat for 4. And pass.
Let's start off with an Oath. Alright, we'll get a Servant of the Conduit.
Feels really good when you don't get punished by the combo for making poor decisions. Crew. And pass.
Step, I'm gonna harness lightning. So I'm getting an energy. We can only assume that he has unlicensed disintegration here, and if he does, no matter what I do on my turn, no matter what play I make, I lose, because even if I don't do anything, he just kills all my guys and then he can kill me. So the only liberal option is, like in with plays like this, is just, sometimes you have to just go for it. If he has it, he has it. So I'm going to cast the Healy. I'm going to minus on the Dark Guardian.
Response.
Okay. So for sideboarded games, I'm gonna cut the Servant of the Conduits and the Chandras, just because like a lot of times with the Chandra minus, you can't hit any of your vehicles, and like the only thing you ever want to really hit on his side of the board is Walking Ballista, and they just like immediately trade with your Chandra, which always feels bad.
Kind of is.
We're cutting one attune. We still need them, but we need to shave on something that's not the combo. We still need that to win. So as far as what we're bringing the 2 dispels, because we've seen that he has. Instant speed answers, and the worst one being unlicensed disintegration, because he can kill the cat and he kills the Healy, so he 2-for-1s this every time. And we're bringing in the 1 natural state. It's just really good against vehicles. Like, there's not really much more to talk about that, but the better card right here, I think, is the Brawl's Exorcist in the sideboard, because at some point he can have like Walking Ballistas out, and I have Healy on board, but I have a cat in hand. Well, and he's tapped out, and the only way that I can win is if I somehow get rid of his Walking Ballista first. So what all I have to do is like plus up on this alien, make it safe from his Walking Ballista ping, and then just return it, like, you know, choose it in some vehicles or whatever, return it to his hand, and then cast my cat.
Yeah.
And there's sometimes where I can get value in a game where I can actually return my own cat to my hand with this, and since the way it's worded, you cast it after everything gets resolved in the first part of the card. You can return your cat and like recast it to balance like an Oath of Chandra or whatever you need. So it's really good. And then obviously the three release the Gremlins, it's our Marty vehicles, you know, tech for that matchup. So that's what we're bringing in.
For us, we're just going to side out the Fatal Pushes because it's not going to actually hit anything unless we can actually initiate Revolt and just bring in more disruption and something to kill his creatures and or Sigili if it makes it on the board.
Seems really awkward. It's probably one land too many, but we already have a sideboard card and we have some, you know, a way to search and, you know, some more mana fixing if we need it. So like this is almost a dead card, but I think it'll be fine. It can set up some really good harness lions.
So here we have probably the best hand that this deck can produce. So naturally, we're probably gonna mulligan so that we can give Craig a chance to win.
How sweet.
So I guess we will keep this. It's not really good, but we don't want to get greedy here. That being the scry, probably we're gonna put it to the bottom to get more action. See, and then you just draw something that's actually good, and the hand just gets there.
AKA Dirty Cheater.
So, concealed. Graven.
Not as scary.
Clue. Go.
Okay, so Oath of Nissa.
And just one of our cards.
We're looking at that.
Combat for one. Good. And pass. You don't want to be turn three crew into a crew.
Just don't want anything.
Scrap Heap, i.e. the real MVP. Tap to crew. Combat for four. And pass.
What, Aether Hub? Alright, if I get an energy, let me immediately use it. Because I'm going to do Fellow Guardian. And I'm going to bounce Oath of Chandra. I'll pass.
We just have to go for this and drop a Walking Ballista for one. And pass.
Ready yet?
I guess
the
tune.
How creative, sir. So, this is what I wanted yesterday.
I get a plane.
Yeah, how many of those other things can you get
to go along with it? We can drop a second cat. And
we got soul warden players, guys. Right here. I know.
Deal one damage to you.
I haven't seen it.
I threw up some stuff back here.
I got
play Aether Sphere. Get it. 2 energy. And we pass.
Here's the Moonbait, 3 Thoughtfears. You guys for all their expertise. Pretty nice.
Do one to you.
Good.
Actually, go into the Thunder.
The Walker Bliss is in your grave, right? Very common.
You didn't want to cast anything in your hand for free?
I did not.
Log. Use some energy. Size. Targeting.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13.
Good game.
I decided, look at me. I'm the beatdown now.
So after a mall, I'm thinking this is a lot better. More action.
Okay. So my hand's not great. It's one of those where it's probably one land too many. I think it's fine. Like, obviously we have a little protection, like, once we get towards the later game. Like, I draw a card, this card's, like, decent. Like, it's not perfect. It's probably a mulligan. But I think it's close enough to a keep. Like, sometimes you don't want to go down too far. Especially once you know you're playing as part of your, because, like, every card's gonna count, so we're gonna keep.
So that's the scribe. Probably gonna put it to the bottom. Because this hand could turn really bad, really fast.
I'll take him, good.
Heart.
Seems pretty good.
And pass.
Good.
At the beginning of combat, I'm going to crew heart.
Good.
Clear attackers. Second main. Force it for 1.
Okay.
And I'll pass.
Play Rogue Refiner. You're going to draw a card and get 2 energy.
Beginning of combat, I'm gonna crew.
Okay.
Swing 4. And pass.
Put hit the hub and get energy. Get rid of the gremlins.
Targeting?
Target crew. Good. Yeah, 2 2. I'll pass.
Get
an energy, and I'll pass.
The top deck for real.
30 to Inspector.
Spell it.
GG. Cats!